Welcome to Melbourne for a weekend of fierce competition. We're a stone's throw from the beach here at the Albert Park Circuit. It might be party mood in the grandstands, but in the paddock, expectations and tensions are high. The Albert Park Circuit is bursting with rapid corners and a long straight where drivers can push their speed to the limits. Good attention to medium speed downforce will likely make beating this beast of a track just a little bit easier. At this early stage in the season, there are still plenty of opportunities for things to change. In this sport, there simply are no guarantees. Okay then, let's get to it. We return to our highly anticipated race weekend, just in time for the start of qualifying. While everyone will be talking about the battle for pole, there is still so much to be contested here today. Qualifying presents a tremendous opportunity for all 10 constructors and their drivers, as a strong performance now will put them in good stead for tomorrow's race. There's not much left to say, so let's get into it. The grid is packed and there's electricity in the air. But there's no surprises in that. It's race day!
Haas gave a solid performance in qualifying, and they'll be happy enough with their grid position here. Let's see if they can make it work for them. Although we didn't see a standout performance from Alpine during qualifying, everything's still open to them during this race. And the race will be taking place under blue skies. That means the teams should be able to apply their strategies without any added complications.
In any case, Melbourne is ready and so are we. So strap yourselves in for the Australian Grand Prix. We have beautiful blue skies overhead as the drivers line up on the grid. There we see Kevin Magnussen. They're in the back half of the pack, so they'll need to work hard if they want a podium finish. And it's Schumacher as the second driver today. Slower than most yesterday, so today they'll be starting from the bottom half of the grid. And we're just moments away now. Get ready for the Australian Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go. Haas with an overtake.
DRS enabled.
With an overtake there. That's a good overtake from Alpine. Looks like Aston Martin have just gained a race position. Is that a new race position for Haas? Looks like that was a position gained for Alfa Romeo. With an overtake. That's a position gained for AlphaTauri. With an overtake there. AlphaTauri gained a place. Aston Martin with a great play there. They've moved up a place. Is that a new race position for Haas? With an overtake. Alpine just advanced. Haas with an overtake there. Is that a new race position for Haas? McLaren with a great overtake. That's a position gained for AlphaTauri. AlphaTauri gained a place. Haas with an overtake. win. Let's take a closer look. Now just take a look at the McLaren. Look at that! They've spun their car. Haas with an overtake there. McLaren gain a position. Is that a new race position for Haas? Haas with an overtake. That's a good overtake from Alpine. With an overtake there. And that's the lockup. Let's take a look at the replay. Now here we see Max Verstappen. And this, yes, there, that's the lockup. Alpine just advanced. And McLaren with a great overtake. Thank you. Is that a new race position for Haas? McLaren gain a position. With an overtake. McLaren with a great overtake. With an overtake there. That's a position gained for AlphaTauri.
Overtake is available if you need it.
Covered that.
Leclerc. Charles Leclerc is today's winner. Kevin Magnussen showing us how it's done. A great result. This is a good result for Haas. More than enough to satisfy the whole team.
That's right. They've made some fine strategic decisions here. And it's brilliant to see them pay off.
And they're in sixth place in the constructor standings at the end of this weekend.
Now the teams will be looking ahead to Imola, where the season progresses with the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. Get ready for some fierce competition.